how did the injury come about, and do you want to just talk us through what it was like from your point of view?
Yeah, felt very good the days before training. We were well prepared for the game. Coming in, you know, just done the normal stuff. Yeah, felt good start. Got up 1-0. We sort of pressed them a little bit. And, you know, we started to get into the game in a really, really good way. Yeah, the first situation really is when I block a ball from the fullback. I think I press Alex Telles and then he kick it long and I get some sort of twist in my leg and then shake that off. Ran a couple minutes, got the ball back, started to run with it again, like a shift, actual acceleration. And then and then suddenly, like, the injury occurs then.
Sander Berge. Oh, who's pulled up. Without contact, I think, which means that is probably internal, and that is probably his evening done.
Yeah, in the moment, you're just sort of a little bit, like, in a shock, like, whoa. I could tell, like, in a split second that I was injured.
Well, there is a concern on the far side after all of that. Sander Berge chasing after the ball with Nemanja Matic, then hobbled as if he'd pulled a thigh, and has yet to return to the field of play. He's going to get some treatment, so we'll keep you posted on all of that. But if
it's
just
a small one in the moment, but yeah, sometimes it's like the hardest and toughest injuries. They can feel not as bad as, you know, as they are really, you know. So lay down there, obviously knew I couldn't play on. but yeah, walked off the pitch really. Didn't feel great, but still, you know, you believe it's not as bad and you're still like trying to sort your head out a little bit, like what happened here is we're up 1-0, you want to play, you know, but you're injured, heading into dressing room trying to figure out what's really happened. But yeah, I could tell quite early, like, okay, this is not great. We'll need a scan. We will figure out more tomorrow, but already there when you lay down, you get all these messages ticking in on your phone. You FaceTime, yeah, mom, dad, brother, agents, yeah, your closest mates, yeah, and they are like, oh, everybody watched that game, so they all knew. And you know, I normally not go down in that way, so me, myself, but also them, they knew this was not great. And then, yeah, with the next days, I knew more and more about it and trying to digest the injury, you know, with time.
Does it hurt?
Nah, it's okay, man. It looks better every day. I mean, I guess on the camera it doesn't look great, but I mean, I feel it. I'm getting more and more comfortable with it, and it's more important how it is on the inside, you know. I don't care so much about the look as long as it thinks it's working properly, and that's what it is. Yeah, I mean, in this particular injury, the first weeks was, you know, on the legs, not do really much, just try to rest, ice, and repeat, you know, just get the time to go and heal up, you know. Started to doing a little bit upper body and trying to maintain some fitness after like 3-4 weeks, you know, and then building on that. And then in week 6 and 7, I've gone away, you know, to see, to get some time off a little bit and then refresh the mind and then get some, you know, just focus on the injury and then get in a different environment and scenery and then trying to just build on that positivity-ness, which I've gotten there, and then, you know, coming back stronger and with more energy back to the training ground, seeing the lads again.
Crazy or anything, it's just like it's average, you know, nice environment, all sorts of people here, you know, like people with the sport, people who has other injuries, you know, but that makes the environment good, and they treat everyone equal, you know, and then it's like when you come back you're hungry, ready for putting in all the work, you know, and that's nice to be here, you know.
Back at the park again as a kid.
Yeah, oh, that's the best, mate. Yeah. It's just like the pitch is like bubbling when you play passes. But then it's like you think about all the memories you had when you were young, you know? Yeah. And that's where you brought the joy in playing with your mates, you know? Like play the summer cups. It's sort of like a summer cup out there in Regent's Park, you know? Like this big environment, so many pitches next to each other, and then all people come out there and they have a just good time. While I do my rehab, obviously, that's tough and we work hard, but again, it just reminds you where you come from a little bit, and then you have a good session.
In the green room with us every day, sort of like 4 days in the green room.
Oh yeah, I guess we had probably the toughest schedule, you know, in terms of load and training in that period, because, you know, we were at that point, what were we, like 6th, 7th, 8th in the league, going into lockdown, won the last 4 out of 5 games, you know, we were at a very good place, so we obviously wanted to build on that, and also the other fact, we didn't know when we would start up again, so it was just, yeah, 9-10 weeks, very hard work, you know, 2-3 sessions most days of the week, and then in the weekend we mostly had off, but yeah, it was quite brutal, some of the sessions, but yeah, that also made me like mental tougher coming into new country, hadn't really, you know, got close enough with my teammates yet to, you know, spend time, and then at that point we were not really allowed to spend time, so it was, you know, just me and myself really in my apartment then, and then digging in and putting all the work that I was supposed to, so yeah, was a tough period, but yeah, I think I came very good out of that, and that made me the man I am today, and that has obviously helped me playing at a higher level than I was in the beginning. Oh, that's always the main motivation to get back out there, you know, that's what you want to do, and it's sort of like sometimes I say it's healthy to become, you'd never want to be injured, but sometimes it's healthy to meet tough times, you know, to come up like with this injury. It's like, okay, it's a really tough one to take, but it makes you grow, it makes you hungrier when you return, it makes you appreciate being a footballer more, it makes you, yeah, put life a little bit into perspective, like when you first fit, enjoy it, and then make the most out of it. And then I would say, like, I've just been grinding every day, you know, trying to get the most out of each session, for each session that you, like, for me, the with the injury, it's not the problem to work hard. That's the easiest thing, I would say, like, to just go into the gym to work as hard and come back stronger, because your will is that strong. But, I mean, the most struggle is always the, you know, it never, rehab never goes like a straight line, you know. It's always some bumps on the road and some small setbacks, and then to handle that mentally and not being able to every day see the progress, you know, that's the toughest part. And then you just have to stick with it, and then just think about that for each day that goes by, then you are closer to the end goal, you know. But in the moment, it's not the easiest to tell yourself. But yeah, been working hard really every day, and then getting back out on pitch is like, you know, it's like so fresh, you know, out there where you belong.
What's the point with the mat there when I don't have my arms on it?
You put the mat there, not me.
That's what I ask myself that now.
Two more.
Process, because if you go too hard too fast, you could be at risk of setting yourself back. And how difficult is that to weigh up?
That's the most important by far, you know, like every day you get triggered and like, oh, I'm almost there, you know, but you're still far away. But there are people around you, sort of, they want to be as positive as you, but and you know, they want to try to hold you back, but you know, they can't really, you know, when you improve, you feel good and you tell them and they are like buzzing for you, and that's really how you feel, you know. And then in one moment you can feel like, wow, I'm almost there, you know, and in another moment you can feel like, wow, how far away am I? But yeah, when they won against Manchester United, that was massive, and you know, what a boost, you know. And I was very happy for them, you know. I know how tough this season been, so yeah, that was a big motivational boost. And then yeah, each day is, you know, different, but I think it's been very like helpful to always have good people around me. And you know, I've been allowed to take my time, you know, it's never been a rush. And then it's just easy, most important is to remind yourself that you have time, you know, is you're not in a hurry, because for each week you spend in a rehab clinic or facility or whatever, it makes you stronger in the long term. So, and you know, it's not like you lose out on anything, because if you not come back 100%, you won't feel that confident, and then you won't be, then you will also remain without an injury the next phase, you know, when you're back out there, because that's the most important, that you come back stronger than you were.
You put on the tunes today?
Nah, bro, I should have though, innit? I should have picked the playlist today.
Yeah, but it's good today, man.
Two power playing before, and I went, who's this? And he went, is it Biggie?
He thinks this is Keenan and Kel, by the way.
This is what Rian said. He said, mate, you've got no culture. You need to teach you a bit of culture, Rian. Yeah,
like,
isn't it, Rian? Who's
possible?
LL Cool J, bro? Who's LL Cool J?
How do you
think Cal's very good, aren't they?
Yeah, very good. These young pups.
What about Cypress Hill?
What?
Oh my lord.
These young pups ain't got a clue to you, honestly, mate.
I have a clue.
Reef, fam, you're killing me.
Big Sander's from Norway, man. Even he knows.
You know who Cypress Hill is, Sander?
I go with Tupac.
And Tupac and Biggie, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, thank God.
There is Eon.
Oh, yeah.
I'll just say it again. Pretty sick, that's it.
Which one's the favorite animal?
Must be the lion, but I can't see it, so I have to go with the camels.
Only ones I can see.
These last sessions. More shorter today. We're trying to do a bit more. Give multi-directional juice at the beginning. Yeah. Easier with today's plan. Multi-directional juice at the beginning is a simple passing. Pure movement quality is a simple stuff related to your position.
Yeah.
And have your aerobic conditioning also running. That's one.
Right then. Which shoes should we go for today?
Is it black and gold day today?
Yeah. Could go better for the outfit maybe, but these are the shoes I should play now. I haven't really watched. Whoa. Wash them yet? They do the magic, mate. Coppers?
Yeah. I mean, went down to London the 22nd. Stayed overnight there the 23rd. I had the operation, which was, yeah, not really difficult. I mean, the surgeon said so. That was not a big thing. Something that is, as people do quite often, you know, and it's not like a massive operation in any way. But I mean, the job got done, you know. Things got sorted out in the best possible way, and you know, it couldn't go better really, which is what you always hope for, and most of the time it does. But yeah, at that moment, you know, you're that early in the rehab that you don't know really what's coming the next weeks or months. So you're sort of still like, you're smiling and happy. Okay, I've done this, now next step, you know. You're just always looking for what's, you set yourself always small goals in injury, but you always aim, you know, when can you see the light in the tunnel, when can we be back playing. But at that moment you don't really know, you're just happy that went fine, and then you can just move on. And then I came back to Sheffield on, was it 24th, and then really just came home. You know, you ice the leg, George comes down and takes care of me, and I went up there and had Christmas dinner, so the next day, so at least I had some good company when family was not down in the UK.
How are you, Sander? Yeah. Good?
First time back here?
First back.
14 weeks, yeah?
World race.
Nice.
I can't wait. I mean, every day you sort of check the schedule, and like you sort of like want to tell the people who works the closest with you with injury, like, oh, should we aim for that game or should we aim for that? And then in the end, you know, they try to avoid that, but like as a person actually playing those games, you know, you just want to get the shirt on, and you know, for each game I watched, you know, it feels like so many games now. But yeah, I guess it's like, what is it now, like 15 games or so I've been watching. But yeah, you're just trying to reach as many games as possible, and yeah, it's been a huge boost knowing that, you know, it was still not at an end phase of the season. Yeah, I believe I will be very fit and good when I return out there.